Given the graph of the function f of x below, we want to graph f inverse of x. Looking at our notes on the right, if f of x is a one-to-one function whose ordered pairs are x, y, then the inverse function f inverse of x is a set of ordered pairs y, x, which means to graph the inverse of the given function, we can find several points on the given line and then interchange the x and y coordinates and plot those points. Those points will be on the graph of the inverse function. It's also important to recognize the given function is one-to-one. We call the graphical test to see if a function is one-to-one is called the horizontal line test. If a horizontal line never intersects a graph in more than one point, then the function is one-to-one. This is important because only one-to-one functions have inverse functions, meaning inverses that are also functions. So let's go ahead and find several points on the graph of f of x and list the ordered pairs. Let's find points with integer coordinates, let's say here, the y-intercept, here, 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 and let's just say here. And now let's list the ordered pairs for the points. We have -1, -8. We have 0, -5, 1, -2, 2, 1, 3, 4, and 5, 10. And if we take these points and interchange the x and y values and then plot the new points, those points will be on the graph of the inverse function. Meaning if the point -1, -8 is a point on the graph of f of x, then the point -8, -1, this point here, will be a point on the graph of the inverse function. If 0, -5 is a point on the graph of f of x, then the point -5, 0 is a point on the graph of the inverse function. If the point (1, -2) is on f of x, then the point -2, 1 is a point on the graph of the inverse function, which is here. If the point (2, 1) is a point on the graph of f of x, then the point (1, 2) is a point on the graph of the inverse function. If the point (3, 4) is a point on the graph of f of x, then the point (4, 3) is a point on the graph of the inverse function. And finally, if the point (5, 10) is a point on the graph of f of x, then the point (10, 5) is a point on the graph of the inverse function. Notice now we can easily graph f inverse of x, which is a line passing through these 6 points, and looks like this. There's one more property that we should discuss when graphing a function and its inverse on the same coordinate plane. The graph of f of x and f inverse of x will always be reflections across the line y equals x when graphed on the same coordinate plane. Here's the graph of y equals x. And notice if we reflect the blue line across y equals x, it does match up perfectly with the graph of f inverse. I hope you found this helpful.